God bless you, dear students. This is your English lesson, unit number 3. Name of the unit is School Days. Lesson is The Schoolmaster, written by Charles Dickens. Students, before starting this lesson, I will let you know about the Charles Dickens brief introduction. Charles Dickens was born on February 7, 1812 in Ports, England. His father was Navy pay clerk and was horrible at handling finances. At the age of 12, Dickens was sent to work at the Warren's blacking factory, where he hated working. His father rescued him from work and was able to send him to day school in London from 1824 to 1827. Charles Dickens is a famous 19th century English writer. In many of his novels, he wrote about schools. He thought that many schools in England were harsh, and he wanted to tell his readers how bad some schools were. The text which I am going to share, it is from Hard Times, which was published in 1854. The schoolmaster, Mr. Gradgrind, wants his pupils to have nothing to do with imagination and just to learn facts. He was a man of facts and calculations, a man who proceeds upon the principle that two are four and nothing over. Students, this is extract about the Gradgrind, Sissy and some pupils. Thomas Gradgrind saw his pupil as little empty jugs to be filled full of facts. He was like a cannon loaded with facts, and he ready to blow his pupil out of the regions of childhood into the regions of facts. Imagination was blown away. Girl number 20 called Mr. Gradgrind, pointing his finger at a new pupil. "Who are you, girl?" "Please, sir, Sissy Jupe, sir," answered girl number 20, blushing. "Sissy is not a name, girl number 20. Call yourself Cecilia," said Mr. Gradgrind sternly. Sternly means very angrily. Cannon mean a big mounted gun which fires out heavy cannon balls at enemy. "Yes, my father calls me Sissy, sir," whispered Sissy. "Then tell him he should not." "And what is your father?" asked the schoolmaster. "Please, sir, a horse breaker." Students, here horse breaker means someone who trains and tames horses so that they can wear a saddle and be ridden. Sissy answers shyly, "So he breaks in horses, does he? Very well. Tell me your definition of a horse." "Cecilia," ordered Mr. Gradgrind. Sissy blushed more deeply and was unable to utter a sound. Girl number 20 has not the necessary facts to define a horse, cried Mr. Gradgrind harshly. He pointed to a pale boy. "Bitzer will turn to you." Mr. Gradgrind's square figure had alighted on Bitzer because he happened to be sitting in the same ray of sunlight which daring in from one of the bare windows lit up Sissy. But whereas Sissy was so dark here, dark eyed, that she seemed to receive a deeper and more lustrous color from the sun when it shone upon her. The boy was so light eyed and light haired that the same rays of sun seemed to draw out from him. But his skin was so unwholesomely pale that he looked as though if he were cut, he would bleed it white. "Bid, sir," Mr. Gradgrind continued, "your definition of a horse."
"Quadruped, sir," Bitzer answered.
Immediately, Graminivorous 40 teeth, sheds coat in the spring, hoofs hard, age known by making in the mouth. Student, lustrous means shining. Quadruped, a mammal having four legs. Here in this paragraph mentioned here, quadruped, graminivorous means a specialist word meaning grass eating. The facts poured from the boy and more would have followed if Mr. Gradgrind had not interrupted him. "Now, girl number 20, you know what a horse is. Facts. You are to be ruled at all times by facts. You must have nothing to do with the imagination. In this life, we want nothing but facts." Sissy curtsied again and would have blushed more deeply if she could have blushed more deeply than she had blushed all this time. Students, Gradgrind was very forceful and spoke very harshly and loudly. He cared for nothing else except what he himself thought and said. That is why the writer has described him as a canon. You know, Mr. Gradgrind calls Sissy girl number 20 because her roll number in the class is 20. This is a fact, and Mr. Gradgrind's ideas about education are based on facts only. While talking about Sissy's father's profession, Mr. Gradgrind assumes an ironic tone as if to suggest that he does not believe her. Sissy was dark-haired and dark-eyed. Bitzer, on the other hand, was light-haired and pale in color. The response of the Sissy and Bitzer to Mr. Gradgrind's questions were quite different. Sissy blushed and could not utter a word. Bitzer was confident and he poured out facts because he was true disciple of Gradgrind. Students, this is vocabulary for you. Cannon, a big mounted gun which fires out heavy cannon ball at the enemy. Debris, broken pieces of something. Flatter, to praise someone dishonestly and excessively. Fragile, easily broke. Regions, areas, turbulent, full of violent motion and agitation. Darting in, move quickly, lustrous, shining. Quadruped, a mammal having four legs. Graminivorous, a specialist word meaning grass eating. Courtesy, being knees respectfully. This is task for you. Why did the writer describe Mr. Gradgrind as a canon? So give the appropriate answer. Read the lesson. School days, school master, page number 51. Thank you and God bless you.